أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. We are reaching the 21st day of Ramadan. In this section, what we find is an essential message as to the understanding of the last message of all the messages that were sent to human beings and to humanity. When it is said about the fact that we know as Muslims that we are the last, and Islam and the Quran is the last message sent to humanity. But at the same time, what we know is that Judaism and Christianity and all the other spiritualities, Hinduism and Buddhism and even atheism and agnosticism, this is not going to disappear. We are surrounded by people who don't share our belief. And what is said in the Quran is, the way you have to be with Ahlul Kitab, because this was mainly what the Quran was talking about, is full of respect, because you should know that this is what Allah, this is what God wanted for humanity, this diversity. وَلَا تُجَادِلُ أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ. You have to talk to the people of the other, the people of the book, in the best manner, the best one, the best way you can. Except for those who are unjust, because you can find people who are unjust. But the essential teaching here is just be just and find the best way of communicating with people who are not sharing your belief. And that's also something which is essential in our understanding of Islam, is that the final message is telling us, deal with this diversity out of respect. You know why? Because God, who created this humanity, wanted this diversity within this unity. One humanity, a diversity of religions, diversity of cultures, diversity of civilizations, and you have to deal with it. Not only by respecting, because respect is the starting point, but you need to find the way to speak in the best way. You need to find the best way. And what is the best way? How are you going to deal with this? There are three conditions here that are very important. First, if you deal with people who are not sharing your belief, you have to listen first. Listening, it's important. Listening is, I'm trying to understand who you are. And the second point is not only to listen, but to try to understand, the value system, to try to understand what it is all about. What is this religion that I'm not sharing, that it's not mine, but I'm trying to understand. And out of this understanding, to respect whatever the people believe. It's not for us to judge. We don't know. So we don't, and we have to listen to what the people are saying about their own religion. We should not try to interpret and to tell the people what is their religion. We wouldn't like to have people telling us what Islam is to us Muslims. So we have to respect this. So to try to find the best way to talk is to respect by listening, by understanding, and also by accepting what the people believe and the way they have to believe. And it's also a way of talking to the people. You know, when you speak with people of other faiths, it's very important not to start by defining them negatively. They are not Muslims versus non-Muslims. This is the way we look at us as being the center and say Muslims and non-Muslims. But we wouldn't like to be non-Christians or non-Jews. We have to talk to the people from where they are. So we are Muslims and we have people of other faith. So Christians, Jews, Buddhists, Hinduists, agnostics, atheists, the way we talk about them, it's essential here. We should not talk in a way which is putting the people in a binary vision. That's not the way. Pluralism and diversity is based on this kind of respect and mutual respect that we need to have to people. It starts with the way we speak, the way we listen, and the way we accept. Don't forget to tell the people you love that you love them. Life is fragile. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.